어이.
Good evening, guys. Welcome to Life of Paulos. Happy to have you here. I'll tell you what, guys, tonight's a pretty big episode. By the way, a reminder, we have timestamps on every video. Feel free to skip forward to whatever story you want. But yes, folks, in tonight's episode alone, we're gonna talk about a major supercar being stolen. We're gonna use the collective Life of Paulos power to help find it. We're gonna talk about Stradman's brand new Ferrari, and the crowd is going very interesting ways on a couple of the choices. And then, of course, we're talking about the whistling diesel McLaren. Yes, you heard that right. And folks, make sure to sub to the channel if you wanna help Megan and I sort of push the Life of Paulos brand forward, doing our best to bring you up to the minute automotive and supercar community news whenever we find it. And with that, Beard Nation, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the show. All right, guys, first off, how do we not talk about Stradman's latest video from yesterday? No, I didn't forget about it. We just had the brand new Lamborghini model to talk about in yesterday's video, which I felt took a little bit of paramount importance. But yesterday, as you guys know, Stradman alerting his massive millions of followers on YouTube and Instagram that a new Ferrari was on its way to the Strad fleet. And we have six options right now to go through. First off, got the Challenge Stradale. That is the car that the entire channel is named after. 430 Scuderia. We have the Ferrari 488, the F8, the F12, and Largo Edition, I believe. And then we have the 812 Superfast. All right, so Stradman put up a ton of polls comparing these cars to each other to get a sense of what his audience wanted, and some of these are kind of surprising. So the first poll he put up, the Challenge Stradale versus the 430 Scuderia. 70% of his massive following want him to get the Scuderia over the namesake of his channel with the Challenge Stradale. Now you might be thinking to yourself, that means that, you know, the newer car is always really gonna win here, but that's not the case, as you're gonna see here in a minute. The second poll that he put up was the 488 versus the F8. Now this is a no-brainer, guys. 64% of the people polled for that particular matchup wanted the F8. I think the F8 is 10 times better of a car than the 488. I'd rather have an F8 or a 458 before I'd buy a 488. For whatever reason, I always felt like 488's kind of looked chunky, and if you put it next to an F8, as you can see in the poll, the F8 lines are just so much better in my opinion. So the first winner was the Scuderia, then we have the F8. And then let's talk about the final matchup here, guys, the F12 and Largo versus the 812 Superfast. A little bit of a closer race here, but the F12 actually won out over the 812. Of course, I'm a little bit biased here. I would also pick the F12, having a Ferrari FF, which is the much cheaper four-seater version of the F12 with the exact same engine. I just kind of like it. What can I say? So the top three picks that we have out of the initial six offerings were the F8, the Scuderia, and the F12 and Largo. So in the comments below, guys, let me know of those three cars, which one of those do you want him to buy? I have a feeling, given everything going on right now, that an F12 might be at the very top of that list. But let me know what you guys think, and on to our next story, which has to do with Whistlin' Diesel. Next up, guys, kind of a two-parter story about Whistlin' Diesel. So he just put up an absolute flurry of posts on his Instagram account. One of them I thought a lot of you guys might find interesting is this one right here, a picture of his R8 saying the R8 is off to Florida for an entire makeover. Any dealerships want to make a deal on a McLaren this week? Just wanted to throw it out there, guys, get you thinking about what McLaren might be coming to the Whistlin' Diesel channel next. But the secondary part of the story here is a lot bigger and more interesting. So here's what happened, guys. Whistlin' Diesel put up an entire post about a video that we actually covered a couple days ago about Cletus McFarlane on his secondary channel. If only rude fans at races could understand this, talking about how entitled certain fans get when they want to spend time with different automotive creators, not respecting people that are getting ready to race, all that kind of jazz. We did a whole video about it. Whistlin' Diesel showing his support here was sort of a tongue-in-cheek message that a lot of people found very interesting. So as a precursor here, this is Whistle and Diesel's way of showing support for Cletus's message in the caption saying, I just want to say that I'm very angered I didn't get a picture with you, Garrett Cletus McFarlane. I know you clearly saw me park my truck in the middle of the track during a pull and block you in, and you acted irritated that I even broke your window to get an autograph for my 37 extended family members and friends. I'll let it slide, but next time you have to realize the meet and greet comes first. Also, I followed you home and took videos of you mowing the lawn. Sincerely, your biggest fan. Garrett simply responding to the comment section below, saying you win. Now, a lot of people had trouble understanding what was going on here, and actually threw a couple comments back at this particular post, and I would imagine Cletus McFarlane's message as well. One particular person called Dasmo Parr, you guys wanted to be famous and you are now. You guys act like there isn't a toll to be paid for your fame. Dudes spending hundreds of dollars on your shirts and hats, and then of course, when they get their chance, they want their moment to say hell yeah to brother with old Cleeter. They are fans and hang on every video and every word, famous and free. These guys will always find your house no matter how tall of a hill you buy. Enjoy your fame and treat your fans right, because one day they'll turn your backs on you guys just like they did to Bill Cosby. Okay? And then you'll miss them. Whistle and Diesel responding and getting tons of likes in this particular statement, saying, not really the point of the conversation here. This is about having some respect and common sense. Now, there's actually a ton of other prominent automotive YouTubers, from StreetSpeed717 to Weston Champlin, all commented in this thread on Whistle and Diesel's Instagram post about sort of dealing with the same sort of issues. I would implore you to go check it out if you're at all curious about this ongoing conversation about fame and sort of the tolls that it can take. It's a weird thing, and obviously, I will save it for another episode when we can sort of dive into it more, but that's what's going on right now, making sure that you guys didn't miss it. Next up, guys, I want to make sure I mention a post that Savage Garage put up about a stolen supercar. Now, getting as many eyes on this kind of thing, it can be extraordinarily helpful. Here's the picture of the car right here. It's a blue rare Viper ACR. Please contact at NateINBoost or Capital Auto Club if you have seen this car floating around. Apparently, this is kind of a rare version of the car, so if you see anything like this, make sure to hit one of those guys up, I guess, or Savage Garage as well. Hopefully, we can find this car. There can't be that many blue Viper ACRs out there that look like this in the exact same spec, and generally, the more eyes we can get on it, the better chance we have of recovering the car. Just throwing it out there, guys, try to do our best to, I guess, do our part. Next up, guys, fantastic video featuring a very unique Ferrari on the Hoovy's Garage channel. This one called Should I Buy This Twin Turbo Ferrari Testarossa Custom? So, I didn't even know that someone had done this to a Testarossa before. If you want to see what a twin turbo, a Ferrari Testarossa looks like, make sure to go check this video out, guys. A very interesting video from Hoovy's Garage. And hey, looking to buy it as well, potentially. So go check it out, guys. Let me know what you think. Next up, guys, had to mention Supercar Blondie's video because I wasn't sure if it was real until I clicked into the video. Now, the video is called The World's Most Expensive Car. They're not lying. It's actually true. I'm not going to spoil what the car is. You might be able to tell from some of the video. It's worth over $100 million, which absolutely makes it the most expensive car on the planet to a certain degree. Make sure to go check it out, guys. Crazy stuff. A very cool experience for Supercar Blondie to have time with that. And hey, you'll know a piece of trivia if anyone ever asks you what the most expensive car in the world is. Supercar Blondie has you covered today. Next up, guys, if you're at all curious about the adventures of Shmi and now painting one of his brand new cars, go check out his latest video, Painting My AMG GT Black Series Transformation to Solar Beam. If you guys have never seen what Solar Beam looks like on a car, I think it's a fantastic color. I think you'll really enjoy the video, and I just enjoy painting cars. So go check it out. Let me know what you think about the brand new spec. Next up, guys, I want to mention the Straight Pipes latest review because it has to do with a car that I don't think gets a lot of credit these days. It's called Surprise Speed 2022 Cadillac CT4V Black Wing Review. So Cadillac, I feel like as a brand, has really been suffering over the last couple years in the sports car division. There's a lot of people that like some of the stuff that they put out, but they definitely don't get as much hype as almost anything else in that particular genre of car. But the Blackwing, it's doing a lot to change certain minds. Go check this out. Let me know what you think about it. I'm throwing it up there because I want to get your perspective on what Cadillac is doing right now. And finally, let's talk about the latest video from Hoonigan. Gotta mention it, huge video game fan, guys. Our Halo Warthog's 1,000 horsepower twin turbo V8 arrives for start. one of the craziest builds happening in automotive YouTube right now. Go check out Hoodigan's channel, guys. If you're a video game fan, if you're a crazy build fan, it's a perfect video for you. I'm excited to see what it's gonna look like when it's all said and done. And folks, I think that's all I've got for you guys today. Thanks for tuning in. We've pushed our vlog filming-wise to tomorrow. We're gonna be doing some really interesting stuff with our cars and maybe some big decisions to make here going forward. Anyway, have a great rest of your day, guys. Make sure to stay safe, sane, and healthy. Sub to the channel if you're not already, and we'll see you later. Take care and bye.